of you have been wondering, rightfully so, where the heck my review is for Ozark Season 2, which debuted on the same day as Jack Ryan. And the harsh reality is that I made the fateful mistake of watching Jack Ryan Episode 1 first and never looked back. Yeah, it's not as good as a movie, but it's pretty darn close, particularly for those of us who love political thrillers. I just gave Mile 22 a good review. This is like right in my target zone. And I would say that not since the heyday of 24, that's an important distinction there, but not since then has a political thriller done such a good job with crisscrossing storylines, edge of your seat tension. I actually did literally get on the edge of my seat for some of the scenes here. I was like, oh my God, hurry up, Jack Ryan, you're so close. And then also cliffhanger episode endings. And I don't know if Jack Ryan would be as potent if it wasn't available to binge. I mean, I was a little delayed because of the holiday and work obligations and personal obligations, but you know, towards the end, I was watching these things as fast as I could. I just really, really enjoyed them. But since it is on Amazon, nobody's really talking about it. That's like the problem. Like if your show debuts or airs weekly, there's a little bit more of a conversation, more of a water cooler effect because everyone's watching together. But the downside of binging is that everybody watches at their own pace. And it takes a really special show to still be able to like be a conversation starter, right? But one can only hope that Jack Ryan is just slow to blossom, but still does, as has the marvelous Mrs. Maisel. Damn, Amazon is making some very good television. Also, Sneaky Pete, I highly recommend it. Now, one nice thing about Jack Ryan is that this is the first time that I can remember Washington, D.C. and the government, wait for it, being portrayed as wholesome and cozy. A kind of patriotic angle usually reserved for entertainment about revolutionary America, right? It also struck me while watching this show that while those of us who are interested in entertainment gravitate towards Los Angeles, and New York is also an entertainment town, but also news and finance, but for people interested in government, they go to Washington, D.C. And that camaraderie and energy and a positive attitude, people are there because they love this stuff. It's very nicely portrayed here. It made me actually want to go visit Washington, D.C. I was like, that seems like a real nice place full of people who are trying real hard. Okay. But while the show is called Jack Ryan, he remains largely a mystery to us. They give us a little bit of background, but the character, you know, it's not really told from Jack Ryan's perspective. Thank goodness they cast the instantly likable and relatable John Krasinski. He does his persona and our relationship with him from other work does a lot of the heavy lifting. Because this show is really more about the Ryanverse, with characters like James Greer and Kathy Mueller making just as strong an impression, and also excellently portrayed by Wendell Pierce and Abby Cornish. I would say this is as much their show as it is John Krasinski's. We'll talk about the other side of the cast momentarily. But really, the show is less about the people in it and more about the politics and complexities and moral gray zones. I thought that was very interesting. And I thought Jack Ryan made some mistakes, but he's learning. This is kind of like Jack Ryan origin story of real CIA work. And at the center of it just happens to be Jack Ryan, who is clearly, by the way, the wolf in sheep's clothing that his French counterpart pegs him to be. I'm excited to see more of that in the already approved season 2. Bring it on! It can't come fast enough. There's such good TV on these days, because of course I just recently posted my Iron Fist Season 2 review, which was also a really pleasant surprise. Don't worry, Ozark is next. Another element that really makes the show work is the incredible inventiveness of its terrorist scenarios. I don't know if you heard, but after September 11th, the government did, I think at least for a while, hire entertainment writers to come up with scenarios. And I think they should still do that, because the people who worked on this show, they kind of scared me at how good their terrorist scenarios were. I mean, I was able to figure them out a few scenes ahead of time, which was fun, like a good mystery, right? But that doesn't make them any less impressive or terrifying for their cleverness. I was like, oh, this is maybe too good. You know, the plan is a little bit maybe too good. And while the main terrorist, Suleiman, certainly crosses a line that there's no coming back from, actor Ali Suleiman, I can't believe they have the same last name. He should have been like, are you guys kidding me? Like, it's bad enough I have to play a terrorist, but now you have to name him after me? But he does a great job, not only overall, but he is heartbreaking, heartbreaking in his flashback scenes, especially his job interview at a bank in Paris. He, you know, Ali Suleiman's ability to show his character's transformation is impressive. Not only his transformation emotionally and where his like his train of thought is and his allegiance, but also he just seemed younger in the flashback scenes. He really sold that it was a flashback. I was impressed. Also, Haz Sleiman as Suleiman's younger brother also manages to be very charismatic despite playing a terrorist. And I did feel bad that in Western entertainment, these are still really the only major roles available to actors of Middle Eastern descent. Come on, Aladdin, you got some work to do. But speaking of Aladdin, Mina Massoud has a blink and you'll miss it role. I was surprised at how small his role is. And I was also surprised that he is teeny tiny. He's like half the height of John Krasinski. They're like, we didn't need any visual effects for Will Smith standing next to him. We just painted Will Smith blue. I mean, Aladdin is pocket-sized. And then also, Dina Shahabi does a wonderful job as Suleiman's wife, who makes a fateful decision that puts her in the middle of a lot of the action. Her storyline is amazing, even if her kids are kind of annoying. Adorable, but kind of annoying, as kids often are, unfortunately, in movies and television. Stop doing that. And while I'm sure they didn't actually fly to all the locations depicted in the show, they did an awfully good job faking them. And Jack Ryan has a very international, legit feel, from the locations to its action scenes. I really liked seeing him work alongside the Paris police for a couple of episodes. I thought that was great. And even some of its special effects. I mean, sometimes they're a little sloppy, like there's an explosion in a building and, you know, they start out in one episode panning down and you're like, that's so digitally plastered onto the shot. But for the most part, they sell it. They sell the story. Now, speaking of the story, I haven't really discussed the story, right? But that's because it's surprise after surprise after surprise. I don't want to ruin any of them for you, because that's really the heart of the show. Let me just say that if you like political thrillers like I do, this is probably the best one on the small screen ever produced. I cannot recommend it highly enough. Finally, as for what I think this means for John Krasinski's career, we've been talking a lot lately about, you know, actors' trajectory, what's a step up, what's a step down, and some of you have pointed out that John Krasinski, coming off of A Quiet Place, is doing this show. He signed on for this show and filmed it before A Quiet Place came out, so, you know, he did what he had to do at the time. And I'm sure this is a very nice paycheck, but it's not going to be winning any awards like Mrs. Maisel does, right? And it's not really a star vehicle, even. I think it just reaffirms his talent and likability as an actor. But I don't think you discover anything new about what John Krasinski can do. And I think it's bolder moves like A Quiet Place, which could win some awards itself, that will really propel his career forward. And he's already signed to do a season two, but it depends how the movie stuff goes. I think if the movie stuff goes well, he'll not do another season of Jack Ryan, and I would understand that. But there are other characters in the Ryanverse that could easily take over, and I'm sure the show would be just as good and exciting. Because again, it's already an ensemble piece. So that's my review of Jack Ryan. Share your own thoughts down below, and if you have spoiler comments, be sure to mark them as such. Also, because I won't be doing a spoiler review for this show, but there's goodies to talk about. If you ask me a spoiler question, I'll double back for like maybe the next week or so, and I will answer them in the comments. So again, write those thoughts down below, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.